In this video, ladies and gentlemen, I will cover Riders of Icarus, a fantasy MMORPG that stands out from other games of this genre by the big collection of mounts you can get, either on land or that can fly. Also, the game lets you choose if you want a tap target or action-oriented combat. Okay, so let's start the journey, but before we do that, support me guys on the fight with the big bad boss on YouTube, the algorithm beast, that can be beaten by creating a lightning shield on the video and supplying with comments on what you think about the game. But the most damage to him will do the subscribe button. Press it and let's defeat him together. The game has the usual classes like Berserker, Guardian, Assassin, Priest, Mage and a unique one, a lolly girl with a big teddy bear for weapon and spells, for all of you guys looking for kawaii material. I picked a tanky melee class like always, I don't know why, but I can pick other classes, maybe a PTSD from mobs doing a lot of damage to me, but it is what it is. I tried to make a handsome looking guy, but I ended up making someone looking like a medieval Jared Leto, or some hipster guy from this century. Anyway, I selected action combat and started the adventure. The game started with a cutscene of my memory. And some dude with a crow looking armor named originally Crow. He woke me up and told me he will get me out of the prison.
Wake up. I'm getting you out of here.
He points me to where I can pick a weapon and then the tutorial phase begins. I fight some mobs. Then we met with a guy that is telling us what happened and how we ended up in there with another cutscene.
I failed. Rondo took her. We were taking the princess to a prophet. She was supposed to study Alora's relic to unlock its powers. This is the power you sold yourself!
After we slay some more monsters, and the big guardian at the end,
you humans, your parole has been denied.
We released some Pegasus, but at plural. Which we ride to the sunset like in some romantic adventure movie. After we make our grandioso escape, despite their best efforts to catch us, we see another cutscene where we are shot with a big explosive harpoon and looks like we crashed into a war zone.
Enemy attack! We're going down! Hold on!
Here, the game really starts and we are receiving our first missions. The zone is a mess, covered in fire and spears landing everywhere from the sky. We talked to the captain and he told us what to kill and what to fetch, like in most MMORPGs. The errand boy is back in town. In this zone, we are fighting mainly with some mole looking creatures. After doing some main and secondary quests here, we can observe the pacing of the game is a slower one, which I like, because in this era of MMORPGs, all of them are rushing you to the endgame and you have a boring experience till there. But I really enjoy making all the level until the end, at least the first time I try a new game. It really is an adventure for me and I miss that in these new games. One thing that I don't like here is that they give you the gift with stronger gear that you open from 5 to 5 levels and it will be an easy experience overall. At this point, I can tell that the game combat is action-oriented enough and the graphics overall looks pretty awesome. I was sent to a war camp of my people, where I saw that you can select a teleporting shrine to be your recall location and you have a stone that will transport you to that whenever you cast it. Here, I learned how to tame the wild beasts of Riders of Icarus.
First tip, select a target and sneak up on him if you can. It's easier that way. Keep low and move in fast. Once you jump on, you'll only have a few seconds to form a bond. It's going to fight back, so you have to fight harder.
The secret is to jump from behind and ride them like a rodeo until they are tired or give up, or press some buttons and they show it to you, whatever works for you. After I catched my first unicorn and mount from my collection, I continued my journey. I met with the captain and presented me the strategy to win this regional war. Destroy the enemy ballistas.
I don't know where those Broggins got their weapons, but they've got us pinned down on open ground. We'll never win this fight as long as the sky is raining hell on us.
It was a tough mission. I had to go right in the middle of their flanks and fought with countless small people, but because I am the protagonist, I succeeded. Then, I was nursing a phoenix, and before I knew it, I was flying on it to save her babies in something like a tutorial for flying mounts. After that, an elf was teaching me how to catch a kangaroo. I used the jump from behind technique. And transformed him into a tinier version of itself to become my pet. Next zone that I got into is like something from a fairy tale. At this point, I'm even more sure than before that the graphics are awesome and I start to stare at the view. After I purge flowers and fairies, I was back into the mole people camp where I met my first defeat. I could resurrect myself because some magic stone I got in my pocket. Also, I wouldn't want to wait 5 minutes for the medical team to come. I got no time for that. When I returned to deliver the quest, they taught me how to extract magic stones from items to upgrade my gear. Then, I received a quest where I had to enchant a wooden sword to plus 5, but I dropped it before because it was useless to me, so I couldn't finish this one. I was really upset because they would reward me with plus 5 full armor set that would be crazy strong, but no, the game decided that I can't buy from nowhere that sword by myself and enchant it afterwards. I had to guess that I will need it because it didn't set quest item or nothing. Good job, game. We appreciate. Then, I was sent to talk to the forest watchman. That brings me a phoenix, maybe the one that I helped, and it brings me to the capital city where I have to meet the king. But before I do that, I was rewarded with a cute chubby griffon with little wings. Such a kawaii beast. After I learned how crafting works in this game, I went to talk to the medieval mayor of the city, or president of the country, the king himself. Okay, so he gave me no reward after I assured the victory with the mole people, so I decided to go to the next region. Some camp near sacred ruins where I tried to tame a reindeer, but apparently, if you are lower level, the technique where you jump from behind doesn't work. You learn from mistakes. I also like that the gliding in this game is something like an intro boost from Fast and Furious cars. The next zone I got into was one that had struggles with some werewolves and some cows apparently. I couldn't let them without any help, and because I am the protagonist, I had to do all the work. After I fought some monsters from here, loot some crates, pick some bags with food, I found little Jeffy and escorted him to the place he pointed. But it was already too late, because little Jeffy was becoming werewolf Jeffy, so I had to kill him. I'm sorry, little boy. An interesting mission was releasing Paul Rabini, a big bunny NPC from an instance zone. Before realizing, I was in the next camp where I had to massacre a lot of these Rabini things, big bunnies, that won't give you Easter eggs. How bunnies are associated with Easter is another mystery. On the next level, I got a crossbow that is applied to the mounted combat. Another aspect of this game, and a pretty cool one, because it is still action oriented and you have to dodge the projectiles of the monsters. At level 15, I got into my first dungeon, where I fought skeletons and golems inside the volcano-like mountain. The instance itself was not a challenge, because it was a story mission and I had the option to solo the shit out of it. I reached the final boss, a bigger golem, and was no match for medieval Jared Leto. Next, I opened the level 15 gift and equipped my new OP items and tried them a little bit. After that, I decided to wrap it up for this episode, but will definitely cover it in the future because it feels like a real adventure, maybe I will stream it. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, let's check the pros and cons, but before we do that, I want to notice you that the algorithm beast is landing an attack on this video, and the only way to defend ourselves is to drop a like shield around this video and supplying our party with comments, but the most effective spell is the subscribe button. Press it and let's win together. What I liked about the game. The game has a really fantasy vibe to it. The combat can be action or tap targeting, depends on what you like. Huge collection of mounts. You can fight in the air. Decent number of classes to pick from. What I didn't like about the game. The game has a really low player base. The pacing is a little bit slower and might be a turnoff for some people. Not so many unique quests, mostly the usual kill or collect. Needs more optimization in some parts. Overall, I think Riders of Icarus is a game worth spending some time into it if you want to relax and be part of a fantasy game where you can catch almost everything you see and transform it into your mount or pet. It has a cool vibe and fun gameplay. It's a shame it doesn't have a bigger player base. So, in the end, it might be worth checking it out, but not investing too much time into it. Irene partially approves. Okay guys, thanks for watching, and see you soon. And don't forget, I play games, so you don't have to waste your time.